TWedge is able to handle multiple devices in parallel. And in this video, we're going to have a look at how this works. Let me introduce our two guinea pigs, if you will. An on-counter DataLogic Magellan 1100i barcode reader that serves as main device, and my Android smartphone with TEC-IT's app wireless barcode scanner will be used as backup via Bluetooth. All scanned barcodes should be stored in a Microsoft Access database through ODBC. And here we go. Start TWedge and open the device list where you will see the default device number 1. For this device, I want to use the USB DataLogic barcode scanner. The scanner is working in keyboard wedge mode. This means that all scanned barcodes are provided as if manually typed by the user. Because TWedge will be configured to store the scanned barcodes directly into a database, I want to avoid that other applications receive the keystrokes simulated by the scanner, so I suppress them. A really neat and tidy device configuration requires a suitable name, of course. As the next step, it is essential to tell TWedge what to do with the data received from the scanner. For this purpose, TWedge provides multiple pre-configured action templates which cover common data acquisition scenarios. The action template Insert Data into Database is just what I need. It saves collected data via ODBC in a database. I choose to go with the empty database, which is provided by the setup procedure of TWedge, and confirm the ODBC data source name. The setup of the main scanner is complete. Pretty easy, right? Now let's continue with the configuration of the smartphone, which is intended to work as a Bluetooth barcode scanner. Add the second device and configure the interface. I use a Nexus Android phone with the app Wireless Barcode Scanner. The phone has already been paired with the PC. I select the same action template as for the main scanner. For a better overview, I rename the device to Smartphone Scanner. The configuration's done. Now let's see this in action. The Start button starts both devices and establishes the device connections. So that you can see what's happening, I open the database with Microsoft Access. You'll find this database in the program data folder belonging to TWedge. The actual device used for scanning doesn't matter. Each scanned barcode is received by TWedge and immediately inserted into the Access database. All scans are stored in this table. The additional data like scan date or scan time is generated through the script. It can be customized according to your wishes. But more on scripting in the next video. Thanks for watching!